OPAL Plus Detector Part 1, Unboxing and Installation Without Bracket. The OPAL Plus package contains the detector, an operating manual, and a warranty. On opening the detector enclosure, the electronics can be seen inside. The Bracket C package contains a ball bracket, an angle bracket, as well as a tamper switch complete with its mountings. You will need some tools, Phillips screwdrivers, slot head screwdrivers, side cutting pliers, insulation, a knife or wire stripper, a spirit level, a measuring tape. You will also need a drill driver with a drill bit of type and cross section suitable for the mounting surface. Use a bit suitable for the size of mounting screws to be used. Additional to the screws, suitable wall plugs. Cable YTDY 8x0.5, a heat shrink tube, and a heat gun. OPAL Plus Detector Installation Without Bracket. First, prepare the mounting surface so that it is as flat as possible. Next, remove the screws located at the bottom of the detector enclosure. After opening, loosen the two screws while holding the electronics board. Move the board up and take it out by pulling it towards yourself. Next, prepare the mounting points on the wall. Begin by determining at what height the detector is to be installed. The recommended height is 2.4 meters. Place the detector base against the wall at the desired height and use a spirit level to make sure it is positioned strictly horizontal. Using a screwdriver, mark the points on the wall where the mounting holes are to be drilled. Be particularly careful not to move the enclosure base when you are marking the mounting points. Use the drill driver to make holes for the wall plugs. Insert suitable plugs into the drilled holes. Secure the enclosure base to the wall using the drill drivers and screws. Using a knife, cut the cable jacket lengthwise. Then, take out the wires and bend them slightly. Cut off the unnecessary portion of the cable jacket. Strip about 1 centimeter of wire insulation from the ends of all the 8 wires to make them ready for connecting to the electronics board. There are the following terminals on the electronics board: 2 anti-masking outputs, 2 tamper outputs, 2 alarm outputs, common ground, power inputs, LED on, off, programming mode on, off, dusk sensor output. Below these, the LED on-off pins are situated. Secure the electronics board in the enclosure base. How the detector is connected to the input must correspond to the configuration selected for that input. In this video, the detector is connected according to the 3EOL/NC configuration. The detector outputs are designated on the drawing with the following letters. A, alarm output. T, tamper output. M, anti-masking output. Connect the R3 2.2 kilo ohm resistor between the anti-masking terminals. Connect the R1 1.1 kilo ohm resistor between the tamper terminal and the alarm terminal. Connect the R2 1.1 kilo ohm resistor between the alarm terminals. Make a bridge between the anti-masking terminal and the tamper terminal. Connect the common ground cable. Connect the lead running to the control panel input. Connect power, plus 12 volts, and common ground. Connect the service input. Connect the LED control input. Connect the dusk sensor output. Hide any unnecessary cables behind the upper part of the electronics board so that they are not in contact with the terminals and the other wires. Close the detector enclosure to complete the installation. To do this, insert the detector cover catches into the holes provided at the top of the detector base. Then, close the enclosure and tighten the closing screw at the bottom of the enclosure.